Well, hi there. I'm here on Shovel Down. And, I haven't made a video for a little while. The reason for that is I put my back out and I couldn't actually walk anywhere. So, but it's better now. So I'm out here on Dartmoor, basically. I'm doing a wild camp. And I've come up here with my tarp this time. It's a 3-metre square tarp. And, it was late to Chagford. I got here about 3 o'clock and then I just walked straight up here. I wanted to make sure I had enough time to set up in the light. There's only about 3/4 an hour left of light. A quick way to check the sun is to hold out your hand at arm's length, put it between the sun and the horizon, and each finger is 15 minutes. At the moment, it's that far, so it's 3/4 an hour I've got. Just enough time to cook some dinner and enjoy that before the sun goes down, basically. Let's take you over the setup I've got at the moment. I've done almost a tent lean-to kind of configuration. I'm not sure what you would call that, but it's pretty basic. Using my walking poles there, trekking poles, they're just pegged out. Same with this guy here. Sorry, I'll keep moving it around, don't I? So let's go around the other end. I've already made a cup of coffee, and I've also brought a different backpack. I'll talk about that a bit more tomorrow. I've had to bring more stuff as you gets cooler, as we move into the cooler nights, you need to bring more insulation, so therefore more bulk. So I need to bring a heavier rucksack. I was at 12 kilos in total. That includes the weight of the heavier rucksack, basically. But anyway, under here we've got the sleep system. So I've pegged out the poncho tarp, which I'll use as a ground sheet, which I decided on last video. Now I'm using the bivy bag again, and I've put my air bed inside the bivy bag. I've also underneath put the foam mat that I hated last time. That's just so that it gives a little bit of extra protection, as well as a bivy bag gives a protection. And there's my black snow down bag in there as well, just here. And that's basically it. It's nice and roomy. But I think this will be the last time that I use the tarp. I'll bring my tent next time, because as we move into the cooler nights, I found, because I use those temperature sensors, I found that my tent can be anywhere from then between 2 and 4 degrees warmer inside than it is outside, whereas a tarp, there's no difference. So it'll add that extra bit of insulation, basically trapping the body heat within the tent. So anyway, that's it for today. I'm just going to basically enjoy the evening here in the early dark. I can't get a signal at all on my phone, so that's going to be fun. But that's all right. That's part of the enjoyment of getting away, isn't it? So I'll see you in the morning, basically. Well, good morning. I slept really well, really long as well. I probably went to sleep about 9 o'clock, and it's nearly 9 o'clock now, nearly 12 hours. But I was awake a number of times throughout the night. It was very noisy. The wind picked up. It's still again now. It's still when I set up the tarp, and it's still now. But as the sun drops, it just was windy all night, and the fluttering of the tarp kept me awake. So it was quite a broken sleep, but I feel quite rested all the same for 12 hours. I'm going to carry on today and head for a second night. I think that's the plan. I had to change the tarp setup slightly. I did have it on guy lines out here, but I pegged them straight into the ground to create a much firmer tent to try and minimize the effect of the wind. As you can see, it's coming in from the side. I think possibly I had the walking poles
too high. If I gave it a lower profile and spread the bass out a bit, I think maybe it wouldn't have been so noisy. I can try that tonight. But it's a lovely day. Look at this view. Isn't that gorgeous? A little bit of mist there. Low mist. I can't speak today. Maybe I've slept too much. But yeah, I'm heading on over that way. The idea is to go over to High Willhays. We'll see how it goes today. Got a long day ahead of us. So I'm just going to pack this down and put it all in my rucksack, basically, and crack on. So I'm all packed up and ready to go now. It didn't take long. Got my pack on. Most importantly, is leave no trace. So absolutely nothing there. So I'm heading on over through that way today. That's that boggy bit of ground. I'm going to walk around that, hopefully. I've got waterproof socks on today. So I don't think I need them because it seems a lot drier than it was last time I was up here. So anyway, let's crack on. So yeah, I didn't think that was going to be that deep. I just put my foot in and basically went right up to, the top of my leg, basically. So I'm nice and muddy now. I was able to pull myself out because it really was just one leg, but it was quite difficult to get out. I had to reverse out. But yeah, I'm just going to wash my trousers in this river here. Okay, well, they're clean now. Just wash them off. They won't take long to dry. Look, they're already starting to dry out now. Literally within minutes. That's great. So I'm just going to walk across that river. I've got waterproof socks on. I don't care anymore. I'm not trying to keep my feet dry. My boots dry. The boots can be as wet as they like, but my feet are nice and dry. So yeah, let's crack on. So I've just managed to find a bit of a sheltered spot. Water has gotten into my USB port, so I can't use my microphone. So this is just the phone audio. I hope you can hear me. A bit of a nuisance, really. Things aren't going that well. Oh well. I got a little bit lucky, but also, I mean, when I got into that bog, stuck in that bog, it was quite difficult to get out. Fortunately, I realised what happened, straight away, obviously. But didn't panic. Panicking is one of the worst things because, the obvious thing to do was probably put in the other leg, I guess. Try and push yourself out, in which case you've got both legs stuck. So, fortunately, I kept one leg out and I was able to basically lean back to where I just walked onto and sort of pull myself back out the way that I came. I should have tested that a little bit easier. Oh, it caught me by surprise, that did. The moors are dangerous at times. I could have been stuck there for a long time if I hadn't been able to get myself out. Wait for somebody to come along and help me. But okay, it is what it is. Sorry about the audio. I'm so out of practice of making videos after putting my back out. That I don't know how this was going to turn out. So we'll see how it goes. Anyway, I'm just about to approach the danger area on Dartmoor. It's the Oakhampton range, but they're not firing today or tomorrow. I don't think they're firing this week. They are firing night and day on the other ranges, but I'm not going anywhere near there. So let's head up to High Willhays. Let's hope nothing else goes wrong. We'll be right back. So yeah, the microphone now is working. The USB port's dried out. My little dip in the bulk. Yeah, that was a bit embarrassed about that, to be honest with you. Was, there was actually a young couple behind me, which I got talking to a couple of times up here. I bumped into them again just now. So they were behind me. So if I did get stuck, they could have helped me. But, you know, there's no phone signal up here, so a bit difficult. Could have been awkward situation there, but still, that's one of my nine lives gone. So I can see High Willhays in the future, in the distance, I mean. Still quite early, only 10 past one. So I'll just take my time, I think. And that looks quite steep. I'll take my time. So yeah, anyway, let's crack on. Precariously on High Willhays. It's the highest point in Devon, and I think it's the highest point in southwest. Certainly is the highest point in Cornwall, Devon, Somerset and Dorset. Yeah, incredible views, very windy up here. So I'm gonna switch the camera around and give you a panorama. I was going to spend another night here, but I think I'm going to head into Okehampton and call it a day. I could camp out here another night, but I'm only, I think I'm about 5 miles from Okehampton, so I'm not going to be camping here. It's just far too windy. So I'd have to go down there anyway, so I might as well just carry on to Okehampton and get home and edit this video. So yeah, recently I've got quite a few subscribers from my last video, and welcome aboard. So yeah, this is not just about camping, it's about walking, and it just so happens in the last few videos I've been coming up to Dartmoor, and in order to do these walks across Dartmoor, I've been having to camp. So it's part of the walking process, and I'm sure that most of you who do, you know, camping, enjoy the hike as well. So, you know, I do walks around Devon, and it's not always focused around camping. Sometimes I just go out for a day out and just go for a walk and just film, basically, and show off Devon. That's what this channel is all about, really, is showing off Devon and enjoying a nice walk. I was going to talk about the backpack. I'll do that another time. So yeah, if you can do the usual like and subscribe and all that good stuff. And until next time, yeah, take care.